Awareness is the first step. Explore the personalization, privacy, and settings in your Google profile, social media accounts, smartphone or watch, and any online services you use, including dating services. What do these services know about you? Do you have the ability to change the personalization settings? Can you limit how your data, including your location, is tracked? You can also seek out privacy statements and policies, which may tell you whether a service shares your data with other companies. This doesn't just apply to social media or search engines. Did you know that Blackboard and other learning management systems have privacy statements? Look it up. The next step is to be mindful of how you search for and consume information. Try following news stories across multiple websites and platforms. Don't rely exclusively on a single website or a small group of friends to give you all of the information you need. When conducting research, use a variety of search engines and databases. See if your search results change if you log out of your account. Or try using a search engine like DuckDuckGo, which doesn't personalize your search results or collect your private data. Don't forget to examine your own biases and assumptions as well. We have a tendency to be more trusting of information that reinforces what we already believe, a phenomenon known as confirmation bias. Online echo chambers can easily lead to confirmation bias, so we have to think critically about the gaps in our knowledge and how our personal views affect the way we interpret information. Finally, get the word out. Talk with your friends and family about these issues. Advocate for companies to be transparent about how they use algorithms and how they use your data. Today, algorithms are often used to determine the jobs you're offered, the cost of your health insurance, and more. So we're talking about a lot more than just online ads. Learning about algorithms is essential to effective and informed citizenship in a high-tech information society.